Good morning, my name is Mário Marques Silva. I am the director of the Department of Science and Technology from Universidade Autónoma de Lisboa, and I'm also a researcher at Instituto de Telecomunicações in Lisbon, Portugal. I'm here today to present a paper entitled Performance of NOMA with Massive MIMO for 5G Communications. I have three most important references for this paper. The first one is on the 5G and beyond, an article published in Applied Sciences, October last year. Another one, also published in Applied Sciences, is entitled Power Order NOMA with Massive MIMO for 5G. This was published this year. And last but not least, the most important reference is an article also from Applied Sciences entitled On the Performance of LDPC Coded Massive MIMO Schemes with Power Order NOMA Techniques. So, initially, I will make an introduction to 5G communications, then, I will present the signaling system designed for NOMA. Performance results will be presented, and finally the conclusions. So, what is the 5G communications? 5G communication should be inserted within the fourth industrial revolution. The fourth industrial revolution is the revolution of the automation, is the replacement of humans by robots. So the four keywords of the fourth industrial revolution is robotics, artificial intelligence, big data, and Internet of Things. So communications between machines instead of communications between humans. So, and 5G gives a strong contribution to the fourth industrial robots itself. 5G communications have been standardized in different releases. The initial version of the 5G communications was standardizing 3GPP. 3GPP stands for Third Generation Partnership Project in its release 15. It was standardized in 2018. So the initial version of the 5G communications was based on the 4G standard, using non-standalone mode. So as we can see from this diagram, the 5G communications has three use cases. One, entitled Enhanced Mobile Broadband, deals with the conventional communications. Enhanced Mobile Broadband deals with high capacity and high peak data rates. So this is a regular communication as the previous generation. Then two different modes, let's say two different use cases were created, namely ultra-reliable low latency communications and massive machine type communications. So these are the most important differences of 5G communications as compared to the previous generation. Ultra-reliable low latency communications, as the name itself says, was specially designed to support communications that are highly sensitive to loss of data. For example, when we have two cars communicating, the level of reliability needs to be extremely high, otherwise an accident may occur. Also, for example, let's suppose that we are doing a remote surgery. Errors cannot or errors bit error rate should be very, very low, such that errors do not occur. Latency is also very important because let's suppose that two vehicles are driving very close one to each other, and the communication should not have latency, otherwise an accident can also occur. So with regard to massive machine type communications, this mode of operation, let's say, or this use case, is specially designed to support, for example, a factory, a smart factory, or smart city, or smart houses, where we employ billions of devices, with low duty cycle, and that transmit very rarely with low power. Okay, so in this case, the reliability is not so important because this transmission of data is very repeats from time to time. So reliability is not so important. So we are speaking about interconnecting sensors. So the Release 15 was focusing on enhanced mobile broadbands, while in 2020, the third generation partnership project created its Release 16, where the two other use cases, namely massive machine type communications and ultra reliable low latency communications, was already implemented, as well as the new air interface for 5G, entitled 5G New Radio, allowing its operation in standalone mode. So, the entitled network slicing was implemented, namely, network slicing means that the network is split in different areas depending on the services that are being supported. Different use cases are employed, and resources are reserved for each one of the three use cases. Finally, in 2022, we expect the third generation partnership project, the 3GPP Release 17, with several improvements to 5G communications, such as improvement to ultra reliable, the improvements to network slicing, and, for example, allowing the remote control of vehicles. So, as we can see, the 5G communications is not one standard, but different standards. And I would like to take this opportunity just to mention that this paper deals with NOMA. It deals with, and NOMA, the most important advantage of NOMA is sharing the spectrum. And sharing the spectrum in order to support many devices with a limited spectrum. And for example, namely for the massive machine type communications, where we will have billions of devices interconnected. There is no enough spectrum to support such billions of devices. So we need to design 5G in the future. The future releases of 5G communications needs to include different ways of implement this concept, such that sharing of spectrum is possible. NOMA is a potential solution for this. That's why that's which the title of this paper. So 5G communications deals now even the first the initial version deals with massive MIMO. So we speak about hundreds or thousands of transmitting and receiving antennas, and we speak about millimeter wave communications. Millimeter wave communications means that we use frequency carrier frequencies of the order of 60, 70, 80 gigahertz instead of the conventional 3 gigahertz. Now we speak about the signaling system design for NOMA. OFDM is, or namely OFDMA, OFDM stands for Orthogonal Frequency Division Multiplexing. We have the most important, let's say, interference that we have in wireless communications is intersymbol interference. So, what OFDM brings a great added value, since we split the spectrum in different parallel subcarriers, and each subcarrier transports a lower throughput, a lower symbol rate, where the level of intersymbol interference in each one of the different subcarriers is highly reduced. So this is an important mechanism that minimizes the intersymbol interference. OFDM is employed in 5G. 5G communications. Another technique that is employed is MIMO systems. MIMO systems, MIMO means to, stands for multiple input, multiplied output, so relating to the transmitting to the propagation channel. And there are different techniques to implement MIMO systems, namely space-time block coding, multi-layer transmission, and beamforming millimeter waves. An advantage of using millimeter wave communications is the increased channel coherence bandwidth. So the bandwidth that is made available is much higher than those available in the 3 gigahertz band. But we have a problem. A problem is that the path losses, as we increase the carrier frequency, the path loss decreases exponentially. So we have a problem. So in order to mitigate this problem, we tend to use beamforming. Beamforming is a technique that we can focus the energy towards our target, and it mitigates, it can mitigate the higher path loss experienced in millimeter waves. An advantage of using millimeter wave communications is that the distance between antenna elements is highly reduced. So in this case, this facilitates the use of thousands or tens of thousands transmitting and receiving antennas in a very small surface. Okay, why? Because the wavelength is highly reduced. For example, for 60 gigahertz carrier frequency, the wavelength is 5 millimeters. So the distance between antennas typically is the order of 2 or 3 wavelengths to for the antenna elements to be uncorrelated. By using millimeter waves, we can place the antenna elements very close together to each other. So NOMA, why to use NOMA? The aim is to allow the sharing of the spectrum. So a power order NOMA allows separating different users that are using the same spectrum, and the separation is by exploiting the different received power levels that different users present. Let's suppose and the receiver separates such users by employing a SIC receiver, a successive interference cancellation. So the successive interference cancellation implements this expression. So taking the received signal, it cancels all of the users that present a power higher than my own power, than higher than the reference power. Okay, that's the way NOMA, non-orthogonal multiplexes allows sharing the spectrum. Naturally, as I mentioned, the NOMA cancels sim the conventional NOMA simply cancels the powers that have power higher than the reference power. Nevertheless, we still will have a certain residual interference with the users that present a power level lower than such reference power, and this can be viewed as residual interference. In order to mitigate this residual interference, we can implement cooperative NOMA instead of conventional NOMA. By implementing cooperative NOMA, the lower power users relay over the air its own signals detected, and a user that is further from the base station and therefore with a higher power can detect their users already clean, their signals already clean of the other interfering users with low power. And this way, cooperative Noma tends to achieve a performance much higher than conventional Noma, non-cooperative Noma, because we mitigate not only we cancel not only the signals with higher power level, but also we cancel the interfering users that present a lower power. And in addition to this, cooperative Noma also exploits diversity, which is another advantage. Finally, performance results. We address the performance results. In this scenario, we have two different users, two different Noma users sharing the spectrum. We implement with four transmit antennas, MIMO system, and 32 receive antennas. And we have two different users, the reference user with a power one, let's say one, and one interfering user with a power level 0.5, which is 3 dB, a power 3 dB lower than the reference user. In this case, since the reference user has a power higher than the interfering user, it can cancel. We can see here that in red we have the maximum ratio receiver, which is one of the receivers we employ, and in blue we see the zero forcing. The zero forcing is a receiver which is much more complex than the maximum ratio receiver, because it requires the inversion of the channel matrix for each frequency component of the channel. The maximum ratio combiner is receiver is an iterative receiver, much simpler than the zero forcing. So in terms of processing of the receiver, it brings a great added value. Finally, the match filter bound is can be as a lower bound can be viewed as a lower bound of this graphic. We can see here that the conventional Noma presents a certain performance, but when we employ the cooperative Noma, the performance is greatly improved as compared to conventional Noma. When we speak about comprising two users, when the reference user has a power lower than the interfering user, then it doesn't make sense to use cooperative Noma, because the reference user is closer to the base station, and then the other user. In this scenario, I just use the seek to cancel the high power user. So conventional Noma is not applicable in this situation. So we can see once again that in this case the zero forcing performs slightly worse than the maximum ratio combiner, and the performance is much better than in the previous scenario. In this case, we don't need to have a cooperative Noma. Now, the previous results were uncoded results. I would like to also present some results with the LDPC codes, which are included in 5G communications. So we have this graphic shows. Comprises three Noma users with powers 1, 0.5, and 2. Let's say we have a reference user with power 1, we have one interfering user with power lower than 3 dBs lower than the reference user, and we have another interfering user with a power 3 dB higher than the reference user. And the MIMO system, with 8 transmit antennas and 64 receive antennas, is employed. So we can see here why the curves with round circles refer to encoded results. The curves with the cross refer to LDPC codes. So we can see that zero with zero forcing and MRC maximum ratio combiner, we have for the non-cooperative NOMA, we have certain results, and we improve greatly the results by employing the LDPC codes. When with regard to cooperative NOMA, we can also see encoded results for the zero forcing and maximum ratio combiner, where the results are almost the same. They perform, those two receivers perform almost the same. While using LDPC codes, we also experience a great performance improvement also in the case of cooperative NOMA performance. Finally, conclusion. So just to finalize, I'd like to mention that this paper considers NOMA and cooperative NOMA associated to MIMO and to a block transmission techniques entitled single carrier with frequency domain equalization. Two receivers were employed, zero forcing, which is more complex, more demanding from the processing point of view. And we propose the maximum ratio receiver, which is much more simpler and being an iterative receiver. 5G communications using NOMA, which supports the sharing of the spectrum, and massive MIMO can be viewed as a potential solution to support billions of IoT Internet of Things devices as required by the fourth industrial revolution. And as the number of NOMA users increases, the degradation of the bit rate performance tends to occur, especially for users that have higher receive power levels. We have seen in this last graphic. Finally, I'd just like to mention that cooperative NOMA brings special added value for users with higher power levels. I'd like to take this opportunity to show a special issue that I'm currently invited editor, entitled Massive MIMO Systems for 5G and Beyond Networks, Latest Advances in Prospects from Applied MDPI, Applied Sciences. I would like to invite you to submit your manuscripts to this special issue. It will be a pleasure to support you. I am available to receive any question you may have. The impact factor for Applied Sciences has been 2.679. So this is relevant, and this is relevant. And as I mentioned, this is open until the January 31st, 2022. So many months are still. And final, last but not least, I'd like to show you my books that I've been edited and published with CRC Press. And I'm available to support you in any way you may, or to answer any question you may have, either directly or through email. Thank you very much for your attention.